Carlos on the Tom Likas Show. Hello.
Hello, Tom.
Hello, Carlos.
Tom, great show. I hear you every day. And what's there to say, brother? You say the truth.
Mm-hmm.
And we're here for you, man. And we love your show. But I do have a little comment. I was looking at the LA Times earlier this week, and it was funny for me to see a dating advertisement ad on the business section out of all of the sections of the newspaper. And it was just funny for me that it says that 9s and 10s, you can find your 9 and 10 at this dating site, at this advertisement ad. And it's in the business section, so it goes to show that everything you say, Tom, is true.
They say you can find 9 and 10 females.
I don't know if it says 9 and 10 females, but it does say you can find your 9 and 10. Business is usually more directed towards men, so yeah, I mean, you put one and one together, guess what? They're catering to men. You can find your 9 and 10 in the business section. Well, of course, for rich people.
Wow.
And you can find the love of your life, I guess.
Well, you don't have to be rich to read the business section. Do they require a net worth statement or anything like that?
I don't know, Tom, but, I mean, how many people read the business section? And for me, the business section is usually for people that, you know, they're out there with money and they have an interest in stocks. And you know, it goes to show me or me, I put one and one together.
Don't people know that if a woman's reading the business section, she's not a 9 or a 10?
Well, obviously, Tom, women are not reading the business section, let alone the newspaper.
What is a 9 or a 10 is reading People magazine. She's not reading the business section.
Exactly, Tom. But, Tom, one more thing before I go. Your word, or Tom, you yourself are human just like the rest of us, and you will pass one day. Tom, we need a book. Your word needs to keep on going, and it's about time we have a new Bible.
We're getting a lot of requests for that.
Yes, Tom. I mean, you have to.
The New Bible by Tom Likas.
By Tom Likas. Exactly.
That's what we're going to call it.
There you go.
Tom, it's Lori on the Tom Likas Show. Hello.
Hi. How are you doing, Tom?
I'm okay.
I do really want to know.
I'm okay.
Good. Hey, I'm calling you. I need your opinion. I hear you give opinions all the time, and people follow them, and they call, and they say they're happy. So I'm about to get married, and I want to know what you think. About 10 years ago, I spent some time as a well-paid escort, and...
When you say escort, dear, are you talking about being a prostitute?
Absolutely.
All right, because, you know, some people actually try to claim that they're nothing but escorts.
Oh, hell no. Anyway, should I tell my future husband this? Now, I've got a handful of friends that know about this. No one in my family, anything like that, but about half of them say... No way, you don't need to tell him. You don't know every job he had before you guys got together. You don't know everything he did.
Well, if he was a gigolo, you'd want to know.
Well, my natural inclination was to say, yeah, I think this is something I need to tell him. I'm pretty sure he's going to be okay with this. I really believe he loves me for who I am now. That was 10 years ago. We've only been together 2 years, so, you know.
Well, he might not like it, but guess what?
He might not.
Well, if he found out after you got married and had a kid, he might really, really not like it.
Yeah. Well, I mean, that's the direction I was leaning.
I think you're better off finding out now because too many people know.
Right. Well, yeah. About 4 people know.
That's so too many.
I think that... I was leaning your way, my way.
Also,
the right way.
Also, I think in order to have a good relationship, you need to have intimacy. And as a man, I really don't like being with women who have all these secrets that their girlfriends know that I don't know. I have no interest in that.
Okay, so let me ask you. If you were going to be getting married and the woman said, I got to tell you something, 10 years ago, I just, for the fun of it, that's the reason I did it, was I wanted to see what it was like. And then I'm like, oh, my God, these stupid, sweet old men are willing to pay $600 for this? So I did it for a while. And so if your girlfriend, fiance, whatever, said to you, Tommy, baby, I did this about 10 years ago, how would you react?
I'd have a problem with it, but that's me.
Would you?
But that's me.
But why? Tell me why.
Simply because I would be concerned that other people would find out about it, and I'm a public figure.
No. Okay. He's not a public figure.
You asked me. You didn't ask me how he would feel. You asked me how I would feel.
All right. So
now, he could go either way.
if you weren't a public figure, would you still feel the same way?
Not as much, but it would bother me. Sure it would.
Okay.
Sure it would. Now, if you told me you slept with 50 guys, that wouldn't bother me so much.
Really?
Yeah.
But if I
because at least you were sleeping with people out of a need you had. You needed to get laid, and you did.
Well, I needed the money.
Yeah, but you didn't need a 68-year-old guy with dentures breathing on you.
Well, he wasn't quite that old.
Well, you know what I'm talking about.
I do, baby, I do. And, okay, well, I mean, you definitely, that's the way I was leaning, and
I think the best thing you can do is to tell him and hope for the best. And, by the way, if he's not comfortable with it, he's not the guy for you.
Absolutely. That's what I said. I said, if he can't handle this, then that means he doesn't love me unconditionally, because unconditionally means no
condition. By the way,
nobody
loves you unconditionally.
That's fake. You love me unconditionally.
Well, on the condition that you stay at the other end of the phone.
That's right, baby.
And that's a condition. But no, but seriously, like, for example, when people talk about unconditional love, what are they talking about? I mean, like, if I take a hammer and hit you on the head, you would have to still love me because you love me unconditionally.
That's true.
If I lock you out of the house for 3 days and don't let you in, you have to love me anyway because you love me unconditionally. There are conditions. And the condition is generally that somebody treat you with respect and treat you nicely.
Absolutely true, and that was a poor choice of words on my part. But
well, I only point out because lots of people use that term, and
right.
even your dog doesn't love you unconditionally. If you abuse him, he'll bite you.
Yes, I agree. And so, right, the bottom line is I do want to know how he feels about this, because I think that I would always be living with the fear that, you know, someone might tell him, and then what? You know, I guess
that's
my biggest fear is having him absolutely blow off the handle and, you know, spread it around and, you know, tell family and things like that. That's probably my only real fear about the whole thing.
Well, the thing is, if he starts spreading it around, the relationship's over and it's irrelevant.
Well, right, but I mean, then a whole bunch of people would know. Of course, then I could always use the thing, well, I broke up with him and he's mad, so he's spreading.
Oh, by the way, do you know, by the way, his family, are they close to your family? Are they close to your friends? I mean, if the whole family knew about it, who else would find out about it?
Oh, well, I mean,
that you know.
Probably a lot of people. I mean,
do you really care if his grandmother knows that you were a hooker?
Probably not his grandmother, but my grandmother, I would care.
Well, his grandmother wouldn't talk to your grandma.
No. No. What I'm saying is, if he got mad and just decided to call up my whole family and go, do you know what your cousin, your sister, your daughter, whatever did, you know, I don't see him as being that way. I really don't. I'm hoping that he won't be, because I'm pretty sure now I've got to go ahead and tell him. So.
Yeah. Well, yeah, but believe me, dear, I'll be here available. If you need me to make the call with you, I will.
Oh, would you?
Of course.
I bet that'd be some good airtime, wouldn't it?
It would be great. And not only that, but I'd be here. I'd be your Rock of Gibraltar.
Would you be? You'd be my big daddy, huh?
Absolutely. I'll be here to pick you up when you're down. I'll be here to help you pick up the pieces if things don't go well.
Well, I'm kind of thinking this isn't the kind of thing. I mean, you know, short of Maury Povich or Jerry Springer, I don't really think this is the kind of thing to do publicly over
you
the phone.
You wouldn't give it to them, would you, please?
Oh, God.
You know the best place to go.
You are. If I was going to do it publicly, you'd be it, Daddy. I promise.
Okay,
but
good.
I think this is probably the best thing to do, sitting down quietly, you know, at home kind of thing.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay.
Just remind him of the big benefit. He hasn't had to pay a penny. Joe on the Tom Likas Show. Hello.
Hello, Papa. Long time, third time.
Thank you so much.
Hey, I work for the largest telecommunications company in the world, and I wish you were the head of HR or operations, because all these women here are always taking pregnancy leaves, leave of absences, and I'm just really getting sick of it because I got to do all the work for them.
Yeah. Well, it's outrageous. And do you get paid extra to do all that work?
No, sir.
No, you don't. So they work less than you do. You get paid the same, and they get paid the same money to be there or not be there.
Right, and they get paid for not being here with leave.
I thought gender discrimination was illegal. And yet, this is perfectly okay with everybody.
You know, and then the women here don't believe that the top 100 women in the Fortune 500 companies are cute. I told them there's not even one.
Yeah.
Is there a website I can check this out at?
Yeah, if you go to Fortune Magazine, fortune.com. You can also reach it on AOL, keyword fortune. They have the Power 50, it's called. And you can see the 50 most powerful women in American business, along with photographs of them. And I challenge anybody to try to have a sexual fantasy about any of these 50 broads.
You wouldn't even do one with a 12-pack of beer or something?
No, not even. It's pretty bad when Oprah's the hottest-looking chick on the list.
Wow, that's pretty bad. Hey, Tom, are you going to be at the Cinco de Mayo at Camacho's again this year?
I'm hoping I am. We haven't announced that yet. You know, we've been there on Cinco de Mayo for several years, and we want to do that again in the City of Industry, and I'm hoping we will.
I haven't missed one, and one of the guys here is going to go with me, and he's the one that let me go last year.
Tell the guys what that party is like.
Oh, it's awesome, man. It is the best. It's better than Disneyland.
It's unbelievable, isn't it?
Yeah.
Let's say hello to Rick on the Tom Likas Show.
Hey, Tom.
Yes, Rick.
Great listening to you, a long-time listener, and I know you have the right idea, especially about women.
Thank you.
Like you, I'm a little older than you. I'm 52, former pro boxer out of L.A., and I've got to say something. It really is kind of disappointing here. You know, I know a lot of us Anglos and stuff, and I don't want to make this a racial thing, have got the wrong idea. They've gotten really buried by women. And as a guy who's been married three times myself, you know, I everything you say is right down the line. Earlier, a couple hours ago, there was a caller and Latino.
Yeah.
And these guys, one thing that I've always really admired at Latinos is they're men with their women.
Yeah.
And this the one guy, he just found a certain weakness about him that really was disappointing. And you know, believe me, he was thanking you for giving him the you know what to do what he had to do. But I think personally, Tom, that he should have just known by instinct if he just followed his culture a little bit greater. And like I say, I hope this isn't in any way meant, because I, as a guy who has fought 12 world champions, or as a sparring partner, I should say, for 12 world champions, include some of the greatest, the Latinos are the best in the world of boxing.
Yeah, well, the Latino community are some of our biggest supporters. 40% of our audience in Los Angeles is Latino.
Oh, it wouldn't surprise me.
And the fact is that what happens culturally with a lot of these guys, and I understand it, is that they're kind of living a bicultural life. So they may have been born in Mexico, or their parents may have been born in Mexico. But living here, they start to get into the American ways and start to become pussified and politically correct. And that they forget the great tradition and culture that is available to them. And I think that many Latino men are hardwired to do the things that we have to teach American men to do. And then many have become polluted by the American culture of pussification.
Mm-hmm.
So that's why we're here, is to remind them of their roots. And their roots are that men are strong and women, know it.
Well, you know what, Tom? I want to thank you and keep up the good work.
All right.
You're doing the right thing. It's taken me a lot of years. When I was young, I was stupid in a lot of ways with women. I worked in the film industry since quitting boxing for a lot of years, so I've had a lot of experience.
Uh-huh.
And just keep up the good work. I love your show, and I love the message you're putting out there for men.
Thank you.
Okay, you take care, Tom.
Thank you, Rick. 1-800-5800-TOM. It's Ron on the Tom Likas Show. Hello.
Hello.
Yes.
This is Ron.
I know, I just said that.
I just got surprised that I'm talking with Tom Likas, and this is...
I'm not scaring you, am I?
Oh, no.
Okay.
I'm surprised that I finally got through. I get a Midwest...
I was starting to think the same thing.
And I'm listening, and... Everything is all casual. I adore everything that you're saying.
Really?
And I had this attitude a long time ago. And I wished I had the education to make the money that you're making.
Me too.
and I speak my mind, and everybody doesn't like it. And I don't get paid for it, which is, I'm surprised I'm on here.
And no one's more surprised than we are.
And as far as for everything that is being said, as far as for the man attitude, the woman attitude, oh, it's totally righteous, because there are different attitudes, and I've been down some rocky roads, and I wished you was there when I was 18.
I'd link to that.
And I never even figured this out, and I wished you was there.
You haven't figured a lot of things.
Show,
thank you.
And I appreciate it, and we're calling from Michigan, and love to hear from this side of the state, because I'm always hearing from the East Coast or the West Coast, and nobody in the middle.
Right.
And okay. It's like, oh, yeah.
Right. And what is your wife's name, Ron?
My wife's name is Della.
Della?
Yep.
Uh-huh.
And she doesn't really like you. And I'm saying, man, I love this guy.
I don't really like you either.
And she says, he's an asshole. Going, no, he speaks the truth.
Right.
And you say the same thing I say.
Exactly.
And we all have to have the education. And I was married at 19, divorced at 23.
Uh-huh.
I went down that road.
Really?
I'm going, everybody told me, don't do that. I never realized until now.
I see.
And we, I personally love to hear the show. I don't hear it out.
I'd love to hear it, too.
I love hearing it.
I'm working when it's on. What?
I hear it from Detroit Station 97.1.
Ah, I see.
And it comes on at 3 o'clock in the morning when I'm driving home.
Yes, that's when they put all the good shows on at 3 a.m.
Yeah, when I'm coming home and I'm going, where's everybody? They're all in bed. I love this. And I
me
appreciate
too.
You.
By the way, is Della there?
No.
Oh.
She's working right now.
She's working. What does she do?
She's a press operator.
She's a press operator.
Yep.
Is she hot?
No.
No, not really.
No.
What does she look like?
Oh, she's a heavy set woman. And I fall into that category, settled down and whatnot.
Uh-huh.
So all these young guys that think they know it all at 18, oh, yeah.
Yeah.
You are, I'll call you the brother, not the daddy, but the brother.
All right. All right, brother.
Oh, yeah, because you do speak the righteous.
Okay.
And you speak it where nobody wants to hear it.
So let me understand, your wife works all night as a press operator?
Oh, she works the 8 hours.
Yeah.
We pull our 40.
And what do you do?
I'm a material handler.
And what kind of material do you handle?
I drive high-low. I work with different... got to move different materials around.
Drive around with different materials.
Yep.
So you're a material handler. You're driving around with materials.
Yeah, well, Michigan, that's the way it is.
Yeah, I understand. Michigan, you have to drive around with your materials. All right, well, it's been just a little slice of heaven here, Ron. Thank you so much.
Well, I appreciate it.
By the way, I want to tell you, no one was more surprised than I was that you got through.
Well, me too, because I
especially after talking to Dino, I was amazed that you got through.
Yeah, he gave me a hard time for a couple seconds, and I, you know, I can.
Then he just let you write it.
I got shocked. I guess I got a nice voice.
I think everybody listening is shocked.
Well, I hope everybody realizes that you do speak the truth.
Yes.
A lot of things.
I'm doing it right now.
And I don't agree with everything, with anything anybody says, but.
No.
That's the way it is in life, and you do speak a lot of the truth.
I do.
And I wish
I could start my own religion.
And I'm...
Wait, if I started my own religion, would you belong?
No.
Why not?
Why would I?
Because I speak the
truth. Well, now that I'm on the other side, because life is stages, now I know now...
You're on the other side of what?
I'm on the other side of what I got to know what to do, which is
take what?
Care of number
handling
one.
Handling material? What?
Take care of number one.
Take care of number one.
And
well, at the Tom Likas Church, that's where we believe that, too.
Oh, yeah.
Amen.
I've been listening for 6 months, and I'm going, wait a minute, where were you?
I've been here. Where were you? And by the way, I don't know if you believe in God, but I'm the highest authority you'll ever reach.
Well, I don't know about that. I do know that I do appreciate listening to that because it kind of like puts me in perspective going, wait a minute.
Oh, yeah. And I'll put you in perspective.
Oh, yeah. And I appreciate allowing to have at least Michigan voice.
Yeah, well, I'm glad. I'm amazed that we don't get more calls like this.
Yeah, because your producer said they kind of like inside 97.1 in Detroit.
Yes, I know, at 3 a.m.
Oh, yeah. And
right
like,
after the infomercial for colon cleansing.
Well,
whatever
yeah.
they have on.
And I do appreciate being on here.
Yes, you told me that.
I do agree with a lot what you say.
Okay, that's been just great, Ron. Thank you so much. Daniel, hello.
Hey, Tom.
Hey, Daniel.
How are you?
I'm okay.
I just want to tell you I'm a longtime listener, first-time caller, and I live in the Hollywood Hills.
Excellent. Now, but I do a disclaimer here before you say what you're about to say.
Okay.
All right. This is a radio talk show where any anonymous listener can call in and say anything. We have no way of verifying what this person is about to say. Maybe he's making it up. Take it with a grain of salt. But we're going to listen to him. We're going to hear what he has to say. But remember, this is not verifiable, at least as far as we know. All right, Daniel, go ahead.
All right. So I've lived in the Hollywood Hills 23 years. I meet this lady at Starbucks in Beverly Glen. And seems nice. She's an attractive, very much older than I am. I'm 23. And I sit down. She has an English accent. And talk for a bit. End up going out that night to a club called Vibrato. And then we go to another place called Nick's Martini Bar. Tom, I'm sure you've heard of these places.
Yeah, I've been to Nick's.
Mastro's.
Mastro's in Beverly Hills. Yeah, I've been there many times.
Awesome drinks.
Yeah.
And then, so we go out again last night. Both times we kiss a little bit before I drop her off. And then I find out today that a very close friend of mine is dating her son. And then I find out through her that her sister is Nicole Sheridan.
Nicolette Sheridan?
Nicolette Sheridan.
Who is, now tell everybody who that is.
Nicolette Sheridan is the hot, desperate housewife. And I find out that her mom's name is Sally Sheridan. She told me her last name was Savalas. And my friend who's dating her son is a...
Well, that might be your last name. I mean, people have stage names in this business all the time.
Oh, absolutely.
Really?
And so I'm just like, I don't want to hang out with her again. She's old. She tries to swallow my face, and she smells like cigarettes.
Come on.
I swear, Tom.
Come on. Well, how did this... Look, you don't want to do it anymore. You did it in the first place, according to you.
I did do it in the first place. But it's... And most likely it'll happen again because I want to have sex with her. She's a hot lady. She has fake breasts.
Really?
They're nice. They're perky. She doesn't even wear a bra and they signify themselves.
Wow. Okay.
So you
have done this and you don't want to do it anymore?
I don't want to do it anymore, but my friends are like, you got to do it some more.
Do you stop wanting to do her when you found out who she was? Or you stop wanting to do her because of your own reasons?
Because she's a...
Oh, no, come on. You can't say that.
Okay.
You can't say that.
I thought you could say that word on the air.
Well, you can, but the point is it could be... this is a litigious society, Daniel, and you know, we've already let you go way out on a limb here, saying something we can't verify. And in fact, I remind everybody, do not take this as the gospel. Take it with a grain of salt. This guy could be making this up, and we want to be on the record as saying we are skeptical about this story.
Tom, we're going to Masters tomorrow night if you want me to prove it.
You know what? Maybe I'll just have to slide in there and see if you're there.
That'd be awesome.
I bet it would be.
Can you do
but if you're not sucking face with her at the bar, I'm not going to believe you.
I'll suck face with her at the bar.
All right. Cigar smoke and all.
Cigar smoke and all.
All right.
Oh.
It's Michelle on the Tom Likas Show. Hello.
Hi, Hi, Tom.
Hi, Michelle.
How you doing?
Do you care?
That's a good question. No, you know, I enjoy listening to your show. Just for laugh value.
Well, if you don't care about me, you don't have to ask how I am.
Oh,
you don't have to feign concern for me.
No, it's a courtesy, and I'm always courteous.
I see.
But, no, I called in to just comment on, you know, the intelligence of the men that you've had calling in on the show. I've listened to it a few times on occasion. But it seems to me that if the women that they were with, if they're with women, didn't work and help support these people, then they'd be out on their street ass out.
And by the way, attention advertisers, you too can reach this prime demographic.
Oh, that would be true, but I support myself, and I have an education, and what's more important, I have the brains to be able to make that education go somewhere for me.
Well, that, you know, that's what I always tell unattractive women to do. Get that college degree, work hard. You're going to have to succeed in the business world.
I was unattractive.
Well, once you told me about all your brains and all the education you have.
That doesn't have anything to do with how attractive I am.
Absolutely it does.
Oh, but it doesn't.
What do you look like?
I have red hair, green eyes. I'm a size 6, and I have a size C bra. Is that what you wanted to know?
No, I want to know how tall you are and how much you weigh, which tells us a lot more than that.
I am 5'4", and I weigh 135.
Ah, there's the rub right there.
Oh, no, it's not a rub at all.
That's the rub right there. 5'4", 135.
Oh, no, I'll get off the line. I'll let you check out my website, and then you tell me.
All right, you'll tell us your web address, and we'll link up to it, and then let people write comments. We'll let them tell what they think.
Oh, you go right on ahead.
Do you have naked pictures there?
Naked pictures? No, you know what? I'm not a slut.
Anything in a bikini?
No, don't do that either.
Really? So what kind of pictures are we going to see? You in a down vest?
In a down vest. Hmm. Never tried that, but that sounds interesting.
Hmm. Okay. Dean thinks we'll see you in a muumuu.
A what?
A muumuu.
In a muumuu?
Yeah.
Highly doubtable.
Highly doubtable?
Not likely.
All right, so what was your point here, dear?
No, I was just, you know, I'm just making the comment that, you know, I was, especially when I was listening to the gentleman talking about women going on maternity leave.
Yeah.
And, you know, I mean, not that he's on the line anymore, but I'm wondering if he is in a relationship or ever has been.
Doesn't matter. The point is, why should somebody who doesn't have children be penalized by having to do the work of those who do and not getting any financial compensation for that?
Okay, but that doesn't have anything to do with the fact that that's a woman.
Yeah, it does.
Because
men, even though men are legally allowed to take what is called parental leave.
Paternity leave.
Parental leave. Most men do not.
Well, that's their choice.
That's not my point.
They have the option of doing that, which means...
If they have children, the point is people who don't have children don't get to take leave at all.
So you're not saying that it's women.
I think everybody should get to take leave because having a child...
You're right.
Having a child is... I mean, if I want to take time off to go bungee jumping, I should be able to do that, and you should have to finish up my work while I'm gone.
Oh, that's called vacation time.
No, dear. You don't take vacation time to have a baby, and nor do the people in his office.
No, they get time off for that. No, and men that are... So you're not speaking...
Men do not have babies.
Maternity leave. No,
it is sexism, pure and simple.
No, exactly. Men don't have babies.
That's my point, though. If you're going to take time off to have a baby, you should have your pay docked for that time, and anybody who has to do your work should get paid more to do your work.
Okay, so if the wife stops working and the husband can't support his wife, because if we were going to go back and do that and go back to the old times where men ruled...
Men do rule.
Then the men would be able to support that woman. I would never, ever have to set foot on...
Again, there's no reason why somebody in your office should have to do your work when you're not there and not be paid for it.
Okay, well...
Just so you can have the lifestyle choice of having a baby, something that has to do with your personal life. And the office is really not our problem.
No, but you've already said that men were allowed to take paternity leave.
No, but again, you're not hearing me. When somebody, there are people who don't have children, men and women, who have to do your work when you're not there. And they don't get compensated, and that's what the caller was complaining about.
Yeah, but you're saying it's not, from what I'm gathering from what you're saying, it's not about women. It's about people who have babies, which is men.
No,
and
people
women.
That don't. Men don't have babies.
Exactly.
It's that, but that's so the. I don't care. The fact that men don't have babies means that men will never have to take time off to have a baby. But the fact is that men and women who don't have babies have to do the work of those women who do. It's not fair.
Oh, it's not fair.
No, it's not. And people who want to have babies, that's fine. But whatever time they take off for prenatal care, whatever time they take off to have the baby, nurse the baby, they should be docked for that time. And then the people who do their work should get paid for all the extra work they do. It's Keith on the Tom Likas Show. Hello.
Hello.
Hey.
What's your opinion on something?
All right.
Got this deal where I want to watch my wife with other men. What's your take on that?
You want to watch your wife with other men? Why?
I don't know. Just a turn on.
Well, you realize that she might be with another man and like him better than you.
Well, it's a strong possibility, yeah.
Do you care? What if she runs off with one of these guys?
That wouldn't be good. That's a risk.
That might happen. Are you willing to take a risk like that?
Well, yes and no.
What does that mean?
I guess because I'm stuck in the middle.
Well, you're going to have to pick one or the other, ultimately.
Okay.
And I think if you want your marriage to survive, you can't do that.
Okay.
Because it's entirely possible. You put your wife with enough men, eventually, she's going to find somebody who's bigger than you are, better than you are, hotter than you are. And as turned on as you're getting, you're not going to be turned on when suddenly she's leaving and then you have to mail her a check every month.
Yeah.
While she's banging the guy that you introduced her to.
Yeah.
Think ahead.
Oh, I have. You confirmed what I thought.
Yeah.
So, I just wanted
to... You know what, though? Can I tell you something else, though, Keith? Yeah. It's okay to fantasize about stuff.
Yeah.
If you want to have that as your fantasy, that's fine.
Keep it there.
Yeah, keep it there. If you do it, you're running a real risk here.
Right.
All right?
Got it.
Good luck.
I appreciate it.
Thank you.